Kichonam la chanchu padu dani kapsu chi dani chuni ki pe sonangi drola penchu sangi drupa sho Kichonam so kichonam la chanchu padu dani kapsu chi dani chuni ki pe sonangi drola penchu sangi drupa sho
Prostrate to the noble transcendent liberator. Homage Tara, swift heroic, eyes like lightning instantaneous, flung from opening chain and jolto, Lord of three worlds, dear born glorious. Homage she whose face combines a hundred all the moons at Tolis, blazing with light greatly splendid, as a thousand star collection. Homage golden to one totus, water born in hand adorned, healing metric of posterity, patience and education her sphere. Homage crown of perfect goddess, actions triumph without limit, relied on by conquered children, having reached every perfection. Homage thrilling with two towery, whom desire, direction, and space, trembling in her feet the seven worlds, able to draw forth all beings. Homage worshipped by the All Lord, Chakra, Hani, Brahma, Maru. Honored by the host of spirits, corpse raised with Gandharva's Yakshas. Homage with her strain and paid sounds, destroying foes' magic diagrams. Her feet pressing left outriding, blazing in their raging fireplace. Homage to a very dreadful, destroyer of Mara's champions. She with frowning lotus vision, who is slayer of all enemies. Homage at the heart her fingers, adorn her with green jewel mudra. Like great masses all excited, all the wretched jewels adorn her. Homage she so joyous radiant, crowning making garlands of light. Breathful laughing with Tutari, subjugating Mara's daemons. Homage she able to summon all her guardians assembly. Shaking crowning with her moon sign, saving from every misfortune. Homage crown adorned with crescent, moon all ornaments and snow shining. Amitabha in her hair knot, sending out much light eternal. Homage she with wreath of blaze light, beyond any fire abiding. Bright stretched up and joy surrounds you, troops of enemies destroying. Homage she who strikes the ground with her arm and with her foot beats it, scowling with the letter Honda, let her rebels shieldless conquer. Homage happy, virtuous, peaceful, she who feels his peace nirvana. She endowed with all the soba, destroyer of every evil. Homage she with joy surrounded, tearing those bodies asunder. Priest of atonement, knowledge, mantra, arrangement of the ten letters. Homage to agency letter, of the shape of silver woven. Life of stamping shakes of three worlds, Meru, Mandara, and Nidia. Homage holding in her hand the dear markings of Teva lay form. With twice spoken Tara and Pate, Tokuri, the spelling poison. Homage she whom gods and bear king, and the king and earth do honor. Honored in all joyful splendor, she dispels refuge and conflicts. Homage she whose two eyes bright with radiance of sun and full moon. With Trishara and Tutari, she dispels severe contagions. Homage for the liberating, Tara blesses every danger. These hearts also spirits yakshas, enemies, corpses who dream during. These phrases with the root mantra, ten prostrations thus are 21.
245. Page 245, Prayer of the Benefits. endowed with devotion for the goddess and recites it to supreme faith, remembering it again upon waking in the evenings, will be granted all consciousness, will perfectly classify all negativities, and will eliminate all unfortunate vibrations. The multitude of conquerors will quickly grant initiation, thus endowed with this greatness, one will eventually reach the state of the Buddha. If affected by the most terrible poison, whether ingested drunk or from a living being, just by remembering will one be thoroughly cleansed. If this prayer is recited 2, 3, or 7 times, it will pacify all the suffering which forms, caused by spirits, fevers, and poisons, and by other beings as well. If you wish for a child, you will get a child. If you wish for wealth, you will receive wealth. All your wishes will be fulfilled, and all obstacles pacified.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
How about today, you guys? We lost 1 hour, or we get 1 hour. Did you not? But you guys look on time. Well, this morning I thought maybe my clothes wrong. I watched my, look at phone. I said, why not? God, they're all the clothes in us. Anyway, today, I think I would like to a little bit explain to the prayers. We do prayers for before start the teaching, after finishing the teaching, we do some prayers. Also, when we do the prayers, there are many different kind of meanings. Sometimes, when I get a letter, I mean, I'm in Naja, that's Susul Lamada, Susul Yetami, more children. Something, that's all.
So even the Lama Tsongkhapa Guru Yoga that you did earlier is supposed to be like, you're supposed to think the visualize Lama Tsongkhapa, right, in the space in front of you, and you're supposed to think that Lama Tsongkhapa is inseparable or one with your own guru, your root guru, whoever that is.
Ani benata da jisun drama rove na ya jisun drama da ani susu lama ni mo ye mele ta ni da jisun drama ya so wa tak tere ba res.
And also like when you are reciting the Tara prayers, you can also imagine or think of the Tara as being one with your guru and then pray in that way.
Ani sharam ni mo de ka mala ya ta sharam ni na ka so ma te na ji ta ma so mo ta go re ta te ne la ko ni.
And when you're reciting the Har Sutra, then you're supposed to think just as it says in the words of the Har Sutra.
What did you mean by "she chanted"? That means, that those who do not do that, then they suffer from sorrow, particularly the most difficult ones.
So, by reciting these prayers, one can accumulate merit and also remove many obstacles.
And if that means that talent or money or things like that, then you can do it.
So if you go into the Burmese or Thai temples, you will see that the monks reciting many sutras of Buddha.
What is it?
And so also in the Tibetan tradition, in order to remove obstacles and to accumulate merit, the monks do recite these prayers, like the 100 volumes of the translated teachings, and then over 200 volumes of the translated commentaries of the Buddha's teaching.
Also, if you guys want to read, we have both. Then anyway,
So the happiness and suffering comes from causes and conditions.
And
so the cause of happiness, you know, is the virtuous action. So,
bena ta ta na ngazo. Bena ane ta longshe ge mo phwa de ta ngo yong ge ta ma ta ngo phu ge ma longshe ta phu ge ma ba. Ndo zo ge wa no ma mo bo zin ba ya ba ta sa ne ba de.
So in this life we are not, you know, deprived of wealth. It means like we have plenty of wealth, or a sufficient wealth. And that is because of practicing generosity in the past lives.
If we have kind of, oh, another word,
contentment.
If we have contentment, if we don't have contentment, never enough. Then that means that Jacob Shemba, Java, Africa, do, and then Java, the rest of the world, that means that something similar will happen.
So if you look at the other countries, other poor countries like Africa or India or China, then this is like a habit.
So you can check the many people in India, some all the other countries, people want to come to this country. They pay, they borrow the money. You know, I say, don't have more than 10 anyway, this.
So many hundred thousands.
Therefore, you know, even in India, they say, So
in India also, like, people pay so much money to come to America, like over over a million rupees, Indian rupees, to come to America.
But first you think, oh, they have a lot of money, why they come? Yeah, but first they borrow the money, come here, they pay back. Anyway, you know, everybody wish to come here, right? You can just check. All the country people. They show this country as a lot of
many good things here.
Then if I say, if you have enough to entertainment,
contentment,
then we are all worthy. We worthy is, you know, really, what's the business, but we are worthy. We have enough because we have. Everything is perfect, you know. When it's cold, we can put heat. Hot, we can put air condition. You know, we have a lot of choice. But then, the young one, that around two, give one, maybe same thing. So, no, no, so many people are showing the young one, but it's.
And so, all these good things that we have now, you know, is the result of the merits accumulated by our previous life person.
Then, that then, I'm so kind. Number. 다 가나 가서 그냥 되고 야곤 되고 왔는데 야 기억 한 말로 저번 뭐 그러면 되고 이 말에서
and also you know we have quite a good body with all the complete senses good looks and so forth that's also the result of previous lives good karma
왜 근데 이 말인자 얘는 된다고 소름들은 동료야 소름도 세요 그래서
but that kind of karma can be exhausted it will be used up
배나 배조 가르면 가르치거나 배조는 양양도 마사는 그 다른 여자들 배자는 돈으로 벌었어.
So just like no matter how much wealth you have, if you don't keep on accumulating as you also consume it, then it will run out at some point, right? Similar to that.
그래야 총받아서 직장이 일을 쓰면 자기가 탐심에 가지 야야 말당도 왔어.
So that's why the business man. Try to make two with one and three with two or more and more whatever they have they try to make more with that.
Right, we can watch the TV. They say call now. the people always say I will give you better things, but I don't know how can they. Then you buy the kind of sawgold. What kind of what piece of glass? No, lot of the sawgold was.
So you have to keep on collecting or accumulating, right? Otherwise, if you keep on using, then it will run out soon.
근데 이 말은 다 나도 양식 다 개왕 남의 강사 대결 다 나서 지금 간지 탄의 여보도 나는데 다 잘해 다 나도 양 개왕 심해 심한 심한을 패배체들이 양 소는 그 속대서 다 변하는 거 그래서
so because of the previous life of karma we have quite good things now we were quite well off and things are good with us but in order to have good things in the future now we have to keep on accumulating in this life.
What? Then the other day, I'm like, oh, then the other day, 나도 서류라마다 예듬에 예매된 데는 다 써왔다가 대례 사와지 아니 다 써는 거 속사와다 발치 세와 다 명확히 말해야 되와
And so best way to accumulate merit, you know, and to remove obstacle is to pray, you know, to a deity by seeing the deity one with the one's guru.
When we celebrate, we go to shopping. We will put whole, you know, what's that? Put a lot of things in the refrigerator. Then we don't buy anymore. We just use that. Then one day the internet. Exactly, sir. Then you better, and that's one of the source. Better than getting any other sir.
And so while you're using the merits that you had accumulated in the past, you should also keep on accumulating more and more.
Then, that kind of, then you, move on, isn't it? That kind of, then you can't really know what you're talking about. Then you move on, isn't it?
So the person with the, you know, with plenty of wealth will not have any, you know, problem.
So
just like you know the person with the wealth will not be harmed by poverty, a person with the plenty of merit will not be harmed you know, by you know, any obstacles or spirit harms and so forth.
And then 사제 좀에도 소셔. 손은 남아 대도 손은 남아 대도 등아 담쳐서 손은 내면 위에 상반을 내려 손으로 해.
And so Buddha himself said that a person with a merit you know, will be free of all the sufferings, you know, problems, and all his you know, her wishes you know, will come true. So right now we're facing a lot of problems, right? Are you facing any problems?
This is we are not enough to work on merit. You must have merit and takaro. Son of so now, Mugiwani, didn't do that. Son of so this.
So that is because of not having enough merit. So if we compare the amount of you know, merit and the non-virtuous actions, then maybe we should have merit more than the non-virtuous actions. So therefore we have to accumulate great amount of merit. And in order to do so, we do all these prayers, recite the prayers.
Oh, today by the, because, that means that the by the means some of those towers, because some of them just around some devas who do not but cheap by involved some of those.
And so we should always think like this, thinking that myself and all sentient beings are same or equal in wanting to be happy and not wanting any suffering. Can you all accept that?
Maybe it's somewhat boring. Kashi kani ya nota chini. Matul neva chigi chigi. Chigi to ya konsa deki wala ni konsa ya ta chigi wala tini susu deva ji yungkuri sami kashi. Ta chetan dole chigi wala to.
So some of us might think that about some others, some beings, you know, they tend to harm others. But then again, also, they are thinking that by doing that, it will bring them some happiness. Without knowing that this is bad or this is going to bring suffering to them, they think that it's going to bring happiness and with that thought that they do those bad things. So like I mentioned in one of these Sunday class or other class that everything, all the problems that we face in this world, you know, even whether it's a small or a great, everything is created by human beings, right?
대형화 대형 소수군 대야지 대화지 야화지 대니 대 그런 재단들한테는 누가 이런 거를 하 먹어봐 대니까 누가 이런 거를 와서.
And then you know, this is done you know, out of ignorance and not knowing the reality, you know, thinking that you know this will bring good, but not knowing that this is actually going to bring bad. And then they think that's going to bring good, and you know, they do that, and then that's going to bring bad. So it's because of ignorance, not knowing the reality.
Can you take care of the
Is that true?
Oh, yeah. You can take care of the other one. You can take care of the other one. You can take care of the other one.
So if you don't think it is true, and you have some example, then you can it up, then we can discuss on that, you know, to make it clear.
Okay, then there's a time on the chip by the same chair. Chair, chew, run the gun, there was the moment of a chip by this.
And so we are all same, right? You know, no matter who we are, you know, whether we are animal or human beings or, you know, gods or demigods, you know, we are all the same in wanting to be happy and not wanting any suffering, right? And also, we do wish, you know, for beings to be happy, right? Do we wish, you know, beings to be suffering?
No.
Just maybe he said, not my enemies. He said, my enemies are better.
Or sometimes we might think, right, you know, those, you know, who we like, we think, you know, may they be good, but those who we don't like, you know, those who have caused harm to us, maybe we might wish, you know, bad for them, right?
I don't know, you guys. Anyway, the little town, not to come back. Kanji, and the same check on that, there was, you know, to some of you, let's know you, let's know.
So anyway, we all, you know, wish, you know, all sentient beings to be happy, right? So even if we wish or we shout, you know, for 24 hours, still would not be happy, right? And we'll not be able to lead others to the state of happiness, right? And so right now, so we should think that, you know, right now I don't have that power, but who does, you know, who has that power to lead all sentient beings to the state of happiness?
Right? Right now, do we have power? Do you call that? Even, no, I don't know, who has why. If who is a wife, maybe they have no power to make to happy their husband and their kids. If the husband, maybe they have not also power to make their wife and kids to be happy.
So right now we don't even have the power to, you know, make the people that are closest to us, you know, happy, right? Like, you know, the husband to a wife, or, you know, a wife to husband.
What did they mean by the tongue on which you talk?
So let alone other people, you know, who are far away from us. And so in this country, like whenever we have some kind of problems, we always seek the help, right? Like if we got into trouble with the law, then we, you know, seek help with the lawyer, right? So why do we seek, you know, help, you know, from lawyers? So that's because the lawyer might, you know, might be able to come up with the, you know, ways, you know, to free us, you know, from that, you know, problem in relation to the law, right? Is that true?
It's true. Otherwise we have to pay lawyer, right? We don't mind, we pay. 근데 이 말은 다 안 주고 다 술을 네 바에 열어서나 다 사지에 주게 됐습니다. 아니 다 나서 샘치다주 누마다 자야기
So we take refuge, we seek help, you know, from someone who has the method, you know, who has the ways, you know, to bring us happiness. And so just like that, so Buddha, Dhamma and Sangha has, you know, the method or the means, you know, to bring us happiness. So therefore, in order to be free from all these sufferings, you know, of the lower realms and psychic extent, we take refuge in the three jewels. So how does these, you know, beings have happiness? I mean, like the Buddha, Dhamma and Sangha, how do they have happiness? I mean, how do they have power to bring us the happiness? So the fully enlightened being, the Buddha is a fully enlightened being. The fully enlightened being is the being, you know, who is free of all the defilements, all the obstructions. And someone who has, who has the knowledge of everything, so there isn't anything that is not known by Buddha, or fully enlightened being.
Tindida, nandu sem nyomu da traya yewa da, trawa yewa da, trapan kandiba sanji ki shingi yore, sirwa.
And since our mind can be separated from the delusions, and how to separate that is known by the Buddha.
Nandu sem da nyomu di kaar yore, sem nyomu di kaar chaya yore.
Can our mind be separated from the delusions?
Maybe you ought to get all the time. I think so, right? So your mind is better.
So, like for example, like attachment, you know, it's a defilement, right? And then delusion. So, is that manifesting in our mind all the time?
Yeah.
It is manifesting? Mm-hmm. Coming what? Up in front all the time?
Really? I don't think so. For example, you say, you buy one new car. That day you have very, very strong attachment. We all, right? You say, oh, my new car, you don't want to, no one hit, no one scotch, very, very strong, right? But maybe a month, 2 months, 3 months, 1 year, then you don't care. The old attachment is gone. My child, that's not what it was.
It's true.
It's true.
But then we attach to something else.
Yeah.
Then we attach to our new phone instead of our new car.
Yeah. But this could, yeah, the old attachment is different, but one thing attachment is, you know, they go away, right? Always not there. Tereza kanji tate pedo res. Tereza chakpa sayate kanji sendo kakashaya yo res. Kakashaya mewa, mewa sawashi.
Kora da mudu yugo arso ora. Taporashi mudu yugo arso ora. Tere mudu majo pesha ora.
Ale, tacho no ma mudu kateno mudu che. Pena. Tumane, niku de chodo chawa lando de vas.
So like if you, when we say manifesting, that means like, you know, it's strong all the time in our mind, right? So is it all the time there? It's not necessarily all the time there, right? Mm. Like when we go to sleep, do we have attachment? When we go to sleep, do we have attachment to our new car?
I don't think so. I don't know.
And so that it shows that, you know, that there is attachment there, but it's not manifesting all the time.
Mm.
when you're angry, you know, when you're angry towards something, you kind of have attachment at that time, right? The attachment, when you are very strongly angry towards somebody, you don't have attachment at that time. That time attachment is hiding behind. Right. It is there in your mind, but it's not manifesting. So because other mind is manifesting at that time. So attachment is, you know, is a mind that sees something, you know, much more beautiful than it really is, and then with that mistaken mind, then it, you know, desires, you know, for that. That's attachment, right? And anger is the opposite. You know, sees something bad, you know, very bad, very negative, you know, more than it really is, and then with that thought, then with that mistaken thought, then there comes this, you know, wish, you know, to say bad things or do bad things and so forth. So that is anger.
Yeah. Ani tere bata kani ni kudi we kapta gesem chemgen chete kala na to chapang tangen chayor mar chayor mar kwa.
And so when we're sleeping or when the virtuous state of mind is manifesting, when the virtuous state of mind is very strong, at that time the attachment or anger doesn't manifest.
Tere de sem to chaji wa mewa yu pero tanga to chawa inas kwa.
So now, so therefore, anyway, so this is not, you know, it's not one with the mind, you know, the attachment. Any kind of delusion is not one with the mind, it's separate from mind, and it can be separated. So for example, like, you know, I'm going to talk like a friend to you now. So when you were young, you had many different boyfriends and girlfriends, right? Many girls and boys that you've been very close with, and then you separated later, right? And so when you met this person that you are so attached to, you know, when you met that person at the beginning, you know, you feel like, you know, like you have to be there all the time. You couldn't even bear to separate from that person for even a half minute, right? Did you feel crazy like that about that person?
I don't know.
And so that is the attachment, right? You know that, right? That's the attachment that's manifesting at that time.
kese che tang, ni ji nam ju ten tang, lo tang tu tang, kangal nang tu ye tawang tong yo res ba, ni me titi kap.
So that, at that time, the person seems to be very beautiful, you know, even the way he speaks or she speaks, and the way he looks, and you know, when he thinks everything looks perfect to you, right?
Tang ni ma chi chi chi, chi ma ni chani chani yo res.
But someday, you know, you're going to get into fight, you know, because of something, right?
Ra ti chi zhe tang niang yo yo, te yong ge ta de ma bo ro ba.
Do you have that experience? And so because of that, then you start to get angry, you know, towards each other's head, and then you maybe separate, right? So when you get into fight and get angry towards that person, so then everything that he does, says, or do, you know, all looks very bad to you, right? Before it used to be so good, now it looks so bad. And so what that, you know, that kind of thing is created by your own mind, right? It's not that the person is truly good or truly bad, right? At one time you saw the person good, that's because of your attachment. One other time you saw the person bad, that's because of your anger, right? So there's, you know, no, so there's nothing changed, you know, from the other person's side. You know, it's your mind, right?
Maybe they don't change, really. One time they both kind of asama yeva, you know? Asama yeva, so.
So, you know, so again, you know, when that attachment reduces, when that, you know, the liking of each other reduces, then again, there will be less attachment. And so anyway, so that shows that, you know, these delusions can be separated from our mind. So, you know, it is true that like the example I gave earlier about the car, you know, that's the attachment, you know, can grow less and less, right? So same with all kinds of delusions, the mind can be separated from all the delusions. And so Buddha, you know, not only separated himself, you know, from the delusions, but he also knows, you know, how to separate these delusions, you know, and how to help others, you know, to be separated from these delusions. And so therefore Buddha has the power, you know, to provide us all the happiness we want, and also has the power to protect us from all the sufferings we don't want. So that's because, you know, he knows the reality, therefore we say he has the power. So sometimes, you know, that when two people get into a fight, and then, you know, even though we're trying to do our best, you know, to help them, you know, not get into a fight, but then from the way we say it, because of not knowing how to really say it, you know, that even cause, you know, wars, and that even cause the person, you know, to get into even, you know, more fight, you know, because of where we are saying it. Because we don't know the right way to say it. And so even though they are not, you know, angry with us, but because, you know, of not knowing the right way to speak to them, and we say something, and because of that, then they become, you know, our enemy also.
It's happened. It's all the time it's going, right? 근데 나도 딱딱 나도 신기 요 삼지라고 지났다 너로 그래서.
And so because of not knowing the reality, you know, we think this is how it is, and then we say that, and then we make a mistake.
어때? 근데 나다 산지 되는 많이 봐. 다 시제 내 차선 네 강도 잡아서 하는 동료 그래서.
And so Buddha is not like that. He knows everything very clearly, just like you see a stuff on this table.
근데 나 산지 코 아니 나도 좁히 네 바에 다 쫙 떼어버려 해서라고 그래서.
So Buddha has the power to, you know, to protect, you know, so that therefore he is the founder of the refuge.
그래서 다 그 쫙 떼어버지 쫙 가려져서 아니 취사리 그만 손을 취사리 쫙 문에 들어 있어.
So how he found the refuge is by teaching the Dharma. Yeah, so Dharma is the actual refuge.
Oh, then he by the Mukhevachan Maches Sanchi Dharma to Song Shah Yes.
So Buddha has taught not to create the 10 non-virtuous actions.
And
so if we don't create the 10 non-virtuous actions, then we will not experience the suffering of creating, of having created the 10 non-virtuous actions.
And
so just like that, he's advised us not to get angry, not to be jealous, and so forth. And so most of the sufferings we experience comes from the attachment, anger, ignorance,
right? And
so the actual Dharma is the realization of the emptiness that knows the reality. But any other practice, any other practice of Dharma, so such as abandoning the 10 virtuous actions or engaging in the practice of the 3 higher trainings and so forth, and can also be similar Dharma. And then the Sangha is like the helper to achieve that protection. and helping us to engage in our practices. And so to the Buddha, Dhamma and Sangha, we take refuge, we ask them to help us, help us to protect us from sufferings. And so you should take refuge in the Buddha, by thinking that I want to help all sentient beings to be free from the suffering, but I don't have the power to do that, so I have to become Buddha to do so. Until I become Buddha, please protect me, from all the sufferings, from all the obstacles, and so
forth.
So you take refuge, by reciting those first 2 lines. Lama and Sangha take refuge until I'm enlightened, and then whatever practices that you engage in, the practice of the abandoned attendant virtues actions, or practice of generosity and so forth, through the power of all these practices, may achieve enlightenment for the benefit of all sentient beings. And so you pray that, to be able to achieve enlightenment. And so once you become enlightened, fully enlightened, then you'll be able to help anybody who wants. Then oneself has freed from all the sufferings forever. And so abandoning 10 virtues action is the practice of immorality. And so that's like the body, the practice of taking refuge is like the head. So without the head, the body can't walk, and without the body, and without the head, body is no use.
Without head, body doesn't walk, nothing is left.
And so first one is the refuge and bodhicitta.
And the other one,
refuge and bodhicitta. First the verse.
And the other one, semesha gumbaya, is it?
And then after that are the 4 immeasurables.
And then also, that semesha is the dhamma, the chava, the dhamma. And katha, that semesha, that kaje, 삼체대저 대원의 대비지나 덤을 늦어들로 동안에 동안에 차원대 별로 아니 대야 삼체 예리 차방에 별로 빠뉴가 내가 지체다는 것도 빠뉴 내가 먼저 와서
And so those are like the four immeasurables, the immeasurable compassion, the love, and joy, and equanimity. So wishing all sentient beings to be free from suffering, wishing all sentient beings to be happy, and seeing all sentient beings as equal, you know, without any bias. You know, so we don't even have that thought now, right? We're not able to see all sentient beings as equal.
Tak dengar travel cerita ni, tak komputer tak capsun logo, ye sembik jamron logo. Ini sembik tu je dengar ni tak travel kare. Cerita sanjuk komputer tu show ni belum logo. Tengji logo tu ni ada kene ni sama tu tu tangkap es.
So whenever you engage in the practice, you should start taking refuge and generating bodhicitta. And so may all sentient beings be free from suffering, and may I be able to do that for them and so forth. So with that thought, then you engage in the practice.
And the tea water at us, and you jump into the topic, because you're a little.
So, after the four immeasurables, then there's the praise to Buddha Shakyamuni, right?
And the tea got up, so I'm going to put it out here. And that Sanjay, I'm not sure, when I did not call it the opener, that is great. That's what I'm going to talk to the lecture. You might have to start with this.
And so, by offering praise to the Buddha, and as he is the founder of the refuge, then we accumulate a great amount of merit. So
when
you recite, if you contemplate on the words, you know, the meaning of those words, or in the prayer, then you know that will accumulate merit and also will
Ane tanda ya benar mana tu, gadai, gadai yang kita cipta sendiri, tak tanda sanjaya dengan susah ini, barat tanda jangan semua kita cipta sendiri.
So the Tushita Pure Land, you know, is the land of all the Buddhas, and this is where Buddha materials reside in.
Lewa, terlebih dah ane jadi semua gunung tu, ane tu ni je cembur, tak dewas ni je cembur ni, ane cembur nama lo pahat ni, ane cembur sesuatu lo bayu ni, ane teh na ni bah. Ani tan nato jiran macam mana? Dengan segi resro.
So, you know, so like it says in the prayers, right, in the clouds, you know, the Dharma, Kaya cloud, the cloud, you know, that's actually the great bliss, you know, and voidness or emptiness, you know, of the Buddha material, in the mind of the Buddha material, that you know, appear in the form of a cloud, and then on that cloud, you know, riding, you know, is the Lama Tsongkhapa and the two disciples.
Yeah. अने देया गदलानी को जो रखोजन शुरू मारे में तो शुरू सो रस और तब से नहीं बचा देया देजी नाम कर से ना ना सोचने तो नहीं पा मुझे सोचने दे रहा हूँ मुझे नहीं देखा लाया अने शालो तो अने जांच तो नहीं दूर तो नहीं बैया अने संगीत चिंपो जेजी देवे अने ठीक हो गया तो शुरू सब हो गया
so then you invite the Lama Tsongkhapa two disciples right above in the space in front of you. And so, like it is not so far, we say, then only at the distance. You know, if you make a full prostration with your body, your tip of the fingers, you know, will just touch, you know, their throne.
Any, orang kat sini saya orang main bola, nampak jenuh macam nampak yang macam. Any, tak boleh cuba dengan anda kudu nanti lor, tak mungkin dia sampai tahu res.
By nature, you know, everyone should think that by nature is one's guru. But in the aspect of Lama Tsongkhapa. So just like you see the statue here, you know, if you should have just like that.
So the second
prayer is in the space I had on lion throne, lotus and moon, venerable gurus, my bride with delight. Praise to your hundreds of eons to spread doctrine, a supreme merit field of my for my mighty faith. And so here, this is one of the seven in practice, you know, where you request a guru or the holy beings to live long. So this is, you know, again, one of the seven in practices, you know, for accumulating great amount of merit. So by making requests like this, you know, you create a great amount of merit. And also it helps, you know, to prolong your own life also. And then after that is the verse, you know, of making prostration, and it says your wisdom mind sees full range of knowables, and your eloquent speech adorns fortunate ears, your beauteous body frame fame the glory of standing homage to you, what were the thing of hear and see. And so that is the prostration, and after that is the offering. It says a pleasant offerings of water, birds, flowers, and so forth. And so this is offering, so if you make mandala offering here, it's good also. So after that is the confession, the limb of course, the confession. So at that time you can visualize light and nectar flowing down, you know, from Tsongkhapa's heart in all five different colors and enter into your body and purify your negativities, and imagine very strongly that all the sins or negative karmas that you have created since being here time has been completely cleared away. So after that is rejoicing. So in the here, you know, you're rejoicing the virtue or the all the good qualities, you know, the qualities of body, speech and mind of Lama Tsongkhapa, who is inseparable from your own Lord Guru. And then after that is the limb of requesting to turn the will of Dharma or to teach. And so not only requesting to come and stay, but and also requesting to teach ceaselessly, for continuously without a break. And then after that, you know, is the limb of dedication. It says, may whatever virtue that I've gathered here be a benefit to all beings and doctrine. And may it make the Venerable Lama Dabo's teachings, essential teachings, especially shine forever. So here you make a request, dedication. So where you dedicate all the merits that you have accumulated, you know, for the happiness of all beings and for the teachings of the Dharma and teachings of the Buddha to remain for a long time, especially the teachings of the Lama Tsongkhapa to last forever. And so then after that, you know, is where you visualize Lama Tsongkhapa as being one with the three family deities. Like I said, the Avalokiteshvara, Manjushri and Vajrapani, seeing one with them, and then you make this request or prayers. And then after that, you know, is the verse, you know, of where it says, "Oh, glorious and precious Rupa, take seat of lotus on my crown." And so, you know, then you request him to sit on your crown and give you all the cities or the realizations, you know, of the body, speech, and mind. And then, so this is the dissolution part, and so you visualize the Lama Tsongkhapa dissolving into you, into your heart and into down into your body and at your heart. And so this is the next verse, is all glorious and precious Guru Pray takes seed of lotus at my heart. And then, you know, with that, by sitting there, please, you know, grant me all the realizations, you know, of the common and supreme. And then after that, there's another verse, you know, it says, all glorious and precious Guru Pray takes seed of lotus at my heart, caring for me with your great kindness. Until spring awakening, remain steadfast. So not only inviting them, but asking him to sit there or stay there until you achieve state of
enlightenment.
So after that is for accumulating great enough amount of merit, greater amount of merit. So if you are lacking with the practice to do, then this is the one of the practice you can do. Because you don't know what you are supposed to do, then this is the practice you can do on a daily basis. And then after that, you know, is the accumulation of wisdom. So among the two accumulations, that means the merit of wisdom, and the reciting Ha Sutra accumulates great amount of
wisdom,
and so it's for that.
And then after that,
you know, you can do the Lamrim, you know, the dedication prayer, and then that can be the whole practice you can do for the whole day. If you want to, you know, add in between something, then also you can add another 21 praises to Dhara and so forth. So if you're not sure what practice you should do, then this is the practice you can do.
Okay? Sometimes people say, oh, I want to practice, I don't know what to do, I don't have any commandments. Commandments say, I think, I'm so lama shi dana, wang shi, wang shi shi ni, wang shi zai sama la, an wang ka tam si sa shi suan se, te song yi jina, da, lama ma, kene, chegi wa rwa se.
So commitment, you know, is something that you know, receive from a guru, like especially by receiving initiations, you know, empowerments. And so when you are you know, empowered to do certain practice, then you are given this commitment, you know, to do that on a daily basis.
And then they talk about commitment, they just use money. I don't know.
So this is not a commitment. So commitment is something that you have to do. You have no choice but to do it, you know. Because you have committed, you know, yourself to do it, so you have to do it. If you don't do it, then you know, it becomes not virtuous action, or you know, becomes a negative karma. But this one is something that you do voluntarily. So you know, if you do it, you know, on your own. But if you don't get to do it, you don't create non virtuous actions. So this is good, you know, to do these prayers, but also, you know, to reading books is very good. So any Dhamma books, you know, that explains, you know, about like the Lamrim, so, you know, about, you know, the emptiness and so forth. So, or anything about the Guru devotions, and that will help, you know, to develop your mind more. And it's good to read those books. So, like, for example, if we read any kind of book, you know, and then our mind gets influenced by those informations in the book, right? So we tend to think, you know, just like what we have read in the book. So if you read a book, you know, about anger, you know, how good the anger is, you know, how anger is generated, and how can you use the anger to do this and that and so forth, then you naturally become angry all the time.
Do we have that book, so how you get angry?
So if you, you know, so So if it is a book on attachment, then when you read that book, then an attachment comes naturally in your mind, right?
And
so when we separate the time, you know, with the meditative, you know, equipoise and post-meditative equipoise, and during the post-meditative equipoise, if you can read the Dharma books, then that will help your mind. Sometimes you will come across with this information where it says that in the teaching in the book, in the Dharma book, where it says if you recite this mantra once, you'll be enlightened. Have you come across with the kind of mantra? It says that, you know, if you even see the mantra or, you know, walk underneath that mantra, you know, all the day will come as clear since, you know, time for eons and eons, and it would be purified just by walking under the mantra. We come across that kind of mantra? So if you are able to do it in the right way, then you can get that benefit, you know, but if you are not, you know, at that level, then you will not receive the benefit. It's not that the mantra doesn't have that power. Mantra does have the power, but, you know, we're not able to do that way. So in a place called Baksadur in India, where the monks were given a place to live when they just escaped from Tibet. So there was this very humble monk. So maybe he was a little bit stupid also, you know. And one day he was reciting this scripture, you know, which contains, you know, all these mantras, all different kinds of mantras. And then there he came across this one mantra. It says that if you recite this mantra, and then after that you blow on your own body, then nobody will see you. And so one day then he did that, so he recited the mantra and he blew, you know, to his own body, and then he, you know, walked outside in the street naked. So then the people saw him that walking naked, and they didn't know why he did that. They all thought he became a mad. And he said, you know, no, I'm not mad, you know, I'm not crazy. I was fooled by this mantra. So if we, you know, misunderstand the information sometimes, then we might act in a crazy way like that. So there are some mantras, you know, or some prayers, you know, where it says that if you meditate on that, you know, in the evening, you will be enlightened in the evening. If you meditate that on the, you know, that in the morning, you will be enlightened in the morning. So with those who are fortunate, the fortune, they will even, you know, be enlightened while they're sleeping and so forth. So that kind of, you know, information is there, which kind of misunderstand our minds. And so that's only for those, you know, who have already gone through all the practices and have reached, you know, to that level where this will be effective to them. And so this is a general, you know, practice that you can do without looking at the book related to the teachings, related to this teaching on the Lama.
Okay, now we get into him. he got what we call it. He didn't change the term. today they changed the term. You just what one.
Did you forget about the time change?
Oh, you lied. Yeah. Oh, you lied.
Yeah, well, I was just. So maybe Sunday morning.
This is our course, you know. Sunday morning, so everybody has vacation. You know, they have to sleep late. You know, I'm always, you know, of course, council, of course.
So I admire those who come, you know, to the Sunday class even more than others.
No. Usually Saturday, you guys, you know, relax a bit, right? Mm-hmm. You can spend with your family, you can sleep more, you can go to shopping, go to watch movies, but you guys sleep early, or work on get up early, time to come here, then most of you spend 2 hours time here. It's good, you know, very emotional this. It's very good. You know, this is a real try to doing practice Dharma, study Dharma. No, it's very good. Okay, then almost transgone. You know, that's what you're
So it's important, you know, to engage in the practice of the Dharma. To do so, we have to know how to engage, and the way to engage is just like what I explained earlier. And so last time we were talking about the small scarves in the path, right?
Oh,
so we went through the drawbacks, you know, of not remembering the death, right? And so there's the so if you don't remember the death, you know, then you not remember, you know, the Dharma. So the first one is, you know, not remember the Dharma. And then the second one is, even if you remember the Dharma, you will not remember it, you know, to practice it if you don't remember the death. So we don't know when the death is going to come, right?
Do you guys know anyone know? Oh, maybe 100, maybe this much, this age? Can be anyone?
Judge.
You guys think anyone this world people can say die this day? So he, this is not cheating this.
Can we say it?
No. That matter, namche chale chiche ngeme sa dey maris.
So it is. it is certain to die, right? We're all going to die, but we don't know when we're going to die. So the time of death is uncertain.
Right. We don't know. We don't need to die. We don't want to die. We don't know when, what happens. Right? We don't know. Do you guys know tomorrow what happened?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We have plan tomorrow. Oh, tomorrow I have to go. Tomorrow Monday, right? I have to go walk. I have to do things. You already planned yesterday. You didn't go Friday, right? Or I can do Monday, the things. Everybody, not just us. Everybody has plans. But sometimes this happens. Sometimes, of course, the most happens, you know. Sometimes there.
So if the death comes before that, then we will not be able to do what we plan to do on Monday, right?
Nima kadimbe gewe shinye jile ya, mechik ya, ane zamachida ya, zamachida, ane mechik ta tore shuma chwa chide, nyaro chide, ta, kare ta nyaro chide, kare ta tama res, ro chuma res, ane ta zama nyato gore, mude nge shuma res, nyato gore res, nyato gore res.
And so somebody, you know, sent a clay pot, to be looked after, you know, to one of the Kadampa masters. And the Kadampa master said, yeah, I can take care of the clay pot, but I cannot take care of the human beings. I can make sure that the clay pot doesn't break, but I cannot make sure that the human being doesn't die. Everyone thinks death will eventually come. Yet they keep the evil thought, but I'll not die today, I'll not die today. Right until they find the point of dying. That's true, right? We all think we're going to die. Well, we always think I'm not going to die now, I'm not going to die today, I'm not going to die this year.
It says
you grasp to the idea that you are not going to die and think, I could practice Dharma next year or the year after. So you are forever procrastinating. You're thinking about the Dharma but not to practice it.
When I go retreat, Charmin, I do more practice. I'm doing more retreats. You guys think about that? You have any plans? Right now I'm not time. I'm family, I have a job, I don't have time. And when I go retirement, then I do better. Most people have this plan. Okay, yes. And then you tell your mother to this, no she can do any of the year, but I'm not watching. Suzuki, Sendiga, two thousand go to win, I mean, take your job, and that's it, all of this.
It says that you remain engrossed in the thoughts such as I want this valuable object. Meanwhile, you are not practicing Dharma, your human life is running out. So we all come here thinking of something, right? And so generally, we don't even think about many human beings don't even think about Dharma, and even if they do, they don't think about practicing it. So they always are left behind by thinking that I'm going to do later, I'm going to do slowly later, and, maybe next year, and so forth. So if we don't think about that, and don't think about the uncertainty of the time of death, then we will not think about practicing
Dharma.
So it's not scary, it's not trying to scare us by saying, oh, we're going to die, and we're going to do
Dharma now.
So this is our ways or means to not let you become lazy.
Yeah, but you don't lazy, don't age, not age, age. That's so much, and it dripped and not drinking money. That thing also is what? Do I go mad? That you dripped and not drinking money.
And then the third drawbacks of not remembering death, it says the drawbacks that you will practice but not practice properly. That's true, right?
That thing also manganese in the world.
So most of us fall into that category.
That you dripped and not drinking money. Not that much of one, send a nice and mallow begin to give it is.
So we do, the moment we think of ourselves as the Dharma practitioner, we tend to do some practice, but we don't really do it properly.
Yeah.
And that's because of not remembering death.
Yeah.
And so not remembering death and thinking that, this life is going to last forever, or being attached to this life.
Yeah.
It says at the moment, at the moment we are Dharma practitioners, but because we do not ignore that this life's trivia, our practice is not at all pure. We study and contemplate, yet unintentionally want to be scholar or famous. And we meditate, do recitations and so forth, thinking this will remove life's unfavorable conditions. circumstances.
Not to check it off. Oh, my monastery, Lord of Chair, Lord of Chair, is a man. Young, that.
So when you say, oh, I have studied this and that much in the monastery, then you unintentionally want to have that fame, being called as scholar and so forth, right?
And I did 3 years of retreat in the park, somebody had seen us on the Hijang.
Some people, they even like when they introduce themselves, they introduce with that practice that they have done for 3 years. And I did 3 year retreat. And so that, unintentionally, they have this wish to become famous or to have a fame.
And they come that you want to change that, that cancer, and the thing you should do what?
So then, like I said, all the meditations and recitations that we do, we tend to dedicate that for the removal of these life's unfavorable kind of circumstances. Then again, we might think that we always request the monks to do prayers for us to be happy, healthy, remove obstacles and so forth. Then that is not correct, right?
You say, no, I just waste money, I ask them some money, it is a place, I do, puja for the center, they don't work in it, and this is my purpose, is I'm successful, the children was. But, the nikabla ya kardana, to samayate, to samayate, deo samche tamche, deo adan tamba, dumadriba, nimche, jengi pache, suchila manongaya, and the chete, yeo samche, cheva yina, and the muse, and the techeva, and the shura, and the susu, and the rukuyo, and the rukuyo.
So when you request the prayers, if you request for all beings, like together, all beings, that is good, that becomes really a good thought. And then you are included in all the beings, right? And then also indirectly, it helps yourself.
And the thing is that Jojila, that Kishati was later, Jojimbo, Tender Kuna Sunday, that Tender Kuna Sunday, Great Jet Javana, no catching it is, the Kuna Nigeria, and it's telling you.
And so somebody asked, what are the results of thinking only about this life are? And Lama Disha said, they are merely the results of this life. So then what will happen in the next life? In the next life it will be born, reborn as an angry ghost, as animal or as a hell being. Because what you did in this life, you only dedicated for this life, so it only works for this life. And in the next life, all the negative karmas that you have created in the past, since the last time, has been there, so the result of that will be the rebirth in the lower realms. So do you feel like kind of lose hope, thinking that if it's like that, then there's no point doing any of these
practices. Right. I do also that, We want to try to be happy this life, right? You say, success is family, I'm happy. There is something that I'm
So if it's only for this life, then there's no point in practicing, right? Then we might lose hope to do the practice. So again, we should not think like that. If we think like that, then that's the obstacles, hindrances from the demons.
The
demons will lead you in the wrong way. So even though you're doing the same thing, it's only the thought that you have to alternate, right? Instead of thinking for this life, you think for the future lives, or you think for the liberation, or you think for enlightenment. So it's just the thought that will change. So whether you have a good result or not depends on the cause, right?
Cause.
So So whether you will have a good harvest in the fall or not, it depends on how well you sow the seed and how well you took care of the field starting from spring, right?
But this is, you guys have not adhered to your old city. Then country people have this more experience.
So it's going to depend on whether you're going to have a good harvest or not. In the fall, it depends on how well you take care of the field in the spring. So whether the person will become a learned or not, and it depends on how well he went to school, right? Starting from kindergarten and all the way up.
High school, college, PhD,
so you might understand this analogy, right? So somebody who become a professor, didn't become professor overnight, right? He became professor throughout all this time, studying all these times, studying from kindergarten. So whatever practice you are doing, whether it is for this life or for future lives, you should keep on doing it. Even though it becomes for this life, you should still do it. And of course, then after that, as you understand more, and then you say, oh, it's not good just for this life, and it's better to do for next life, and better to do for even for liberation, or even best to do it for enlightenment, for the benefit of all sentients, things like that. Then eventually, then you'll have that right thought, for what purpose you want to do this practice.
Okay.
So it is very important to study first. You should study as much as possible at the beginning. So if you study, then you understand. If you know, you will know it. If you know it, then you can apply it. So we'll stop here for today. And if you have any questions, you can ask questions now.
So I do understand that the benefit of remembering previous lives, because if you remember it, then you will believe in the rebirth, and if you believe in rebirth, then you won't be just living for this life, you will be living for the next life as well. But the thing is, though, why is it so hard to remember your past life, right? I yet to meet anybody who told me that they remember their past life. I read about it, I saw in some YouTube videos about the little boy remembering his past life and things like that. But normally, it's people practicing. I've never seen anybody remembering past life. And if the consciousness is truly continuous, right, of my past life consciousness, and this consciousness is truly continuous, then why is there some seem to be a break point when you reborn, kind of everything resets, and you forget about your past life, and then you just born this world. Seems that way, since I don't remember my past life. So why is it so hard to remember that?
Kyo ngama tenko ures. 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 K So you don't have to remember the past life, but of course it would be helpful if you can remember, right? But you don't have to remember the past life in order to do the practice. Of course, if you remember and you know about past life, then you will have no problem believing about future life, right? And so there's a benefit there. But in order to practice Dharma, you don't have to. You know, we can explain to somebody or we can explain to ourselves that there is a future life by some reasonings, right? And there was a past life by some reasonings, we can find out about that. And through the explanation and through, you know, the teachings, you know, we can understand. So we can come to believe that. Of course, it will be helpful, but you don't have to. You don't have to remember the past life in order to, you know, believe in the future lives. You don't have to. And regarding the consciousness, yes, it is true that consciousness, you know, is continuous. It never stops. It goes from life to life. You know. But like you said, it gets reset. You know. That's because you change the person. You know, the person changes. The mind, the consciousness is the same. It's the same, not the same, but same continuum. We say same continuum. If you say same, that will be a big debate again about that. But it's the same continuum, you know. So from the past life to this life, and from this life to the next life, and it continues. It keeps on continuing all the time, but it changes. You know, different. It changes. The person who possesses that consciousness changes. So past life, we don't know what you were, but this life you're a human being, and next life we don't know what you're going to be. Maybe an animal or something. You know. So it depends, right? So when you become animal, of course you don't remember anything that you have. You know, you were when you were human beings. So that's what happens. And then, you know, the memory is the other thing in the consciousness, right? The memory, you know, it becomes fresh and then it loses and so forth. And even while we're alive, you know, even in lifetime, we don't remember everything. You know, so that's like the memory, you know, so what we did, you know, and everything's memory. And then this life, we forget everything. And so like there are some people, you know, who can remember their past life, but they can remember only at their early ages, like when they're 2 or 3 years old or 4 years old, you know, they can remember most of their past life. But then that same person, when they grow older and older, when they're in their 20s, they don't remember most of it. Maybe there are a few, you know, one or two people who really remember, but most of them, they already forget. Even though they remember at the time when they were like 4 or 5 years old, but when they're in their 20s, they forget everything. And so, you know, it is difficult, you know. You know, I mean, we can't remember, we can't see, we don't remember it, but we can believe in past lives. And so the reason why we believe is because of the logical reasons, you know, not just somebody said it and then you believe it. That would be, you know, a stupid, you know, belief, right? And so you have to prove it, you know, with the logical reasonings, you know, how there is a past and future lives. So like, you know, you believe already, you know, you already know that it's the same continuum of consciousness, right? For past life to this life. It's a different, you know, consciousness. It's the same continuum, but different consciousnesses. And so the consciousness, you know, of that boy, like you, you know, when you were 5 years old. So this continuum, this consciousness that you have now, it is the same continuum of you when you were 5 years old, right? But it's a different consciousness, right? It's not the same consciousness. And so that consciousness only, you know, I mean, that's different from this consciousness, because that consciousness doesn't know many things, right? you know, as a 4 year old, 5 year old boy, you didn't know many things. You know, you didn't know even how to poop, you know, properly, right? And this consciousness know a lot more things, you know, so this is much different, you know, than that consciousness. So does that make sense? Can you accept that it is a different consciousness? It's the same continuum, but different consciousness.
Right.
I mean, so when I was a boy, I had a consciousness that's different
from what I am now. But then I guess the difference is compared to the previous life consciousness that I have a memory of that. What I have, I guess, physical continuum helps to sort of convince you that consciousness continuum of this consciousness. Whereas if I don't have memory of my physical body of my past life, it's hard to sort of connect the dots. So that's the kind of.
그러니까 또 로마기 있다다 남친들 그러니까 텐트 걸었어 수부디 걸 텐트 걸었어 이나 겨울 아마기 수부디 텐트 그 매워 있어 아니 대대대네 남친 눈치 보면 가르스 또 그랬어
대대나도 또 그러잖아
또 그랬어
나도 또 그거 말을 와 또 그거 말했어 남친 제 친구한테 갔나 아니 그냥 겨울 엄마가야 보지나 겨울 엄마가 부모지 겨울에서 봐야나 남친 제 친구한테 남친 가가셔서 말을 와 텐데 가도 로는 그걸 가라 믿어
Yeah, you don't have to remember, right? Of course, you know, when 5 years old, you know, you might be able to remember, but many of us, we don't remember what we were when we were 5 years old, you know, what kind of body we had, how tall were we, you know, what was our shape, you know. And it's all different, right? So even though you have the vague you know, idea that, oh yeah, you know, when I was 5 years old, definitely I was there when I was five, because I couldn't be 20 years old if I was not 5 years old. Yeah, so you can from that logic you can see that yeah that's right. But you don't really remember everything that you were, you know, that you were when you were 5 years old. So just like that, you know. But it doesn't matter whether you remember or not. The fact is that it's the continuum of that, right? Even if you remember or not, the fact of the consciousness that you have right now is the continuum of the consciousness when you were 5 years old. So same like that, you know. So this that continues, that mind of you know, that consciousness, you know, the 5 year old was continuum, you know, from the 1 year old, and that was from the womb, and that was before that, and that was past life. And so when you go like that, you know, then it shows that it is continuum of that, you know, whether you remember or not, you know, that's the fact. And so when you are born in you know in next life as a different being. Then it's a different consciousness. In this life you are a man, and if in next life you are born as a female, or last life, you know, in the previous life if you are a female and you know you have a female consciousness, and this life you are a male, and you have a male consciousness. So that's different. Even though they are same continuum, but they are different consciousnesses. Yeah. So you know, we have to think a lot on this one.
옛날에 그걸 로마 조카라야 아니 템바데 템보 근데 템바데 세토 요래서 근데 야 체체나 아니 야 지금 요모 말 마치는데 템바데 만 냠도 요래서
so of course it is true that when you're younger your memories are more you know, fresh you know, you can remember more things you know when you're younger but then as you grow older and older then the memory also decreases and you know, you have less and less things to remember
근데 야가라야 아니 부모실라야 바와마 시요래
So, you know, in India, there was this girl, you know, who had four parents, you know, parents from previous life and parents of this life. So there are some people who can remember their past lives, but most of you know people don't remember. That's because of their delusions, you know, that they forget it all the time.
그거 아니 일단 레터부터 두 번째 봐야 돼 아니 전바디 이게 제일 많아 보지 뭐 많이 안 그래서
and so your obscuration your delusion is you know, very thick and that's not able to retain or hold the memory and then it decreases
단단 말서 이제 시바 처음부터 먹어 가지고 중요한 제도 내가 제도를 말했어 너무 수치라는 말
so there are many different level of consciousness in our mind you know, there are some very subtle consciousnesses They are not even able to function because of this heavy or thick delusions that we have in our mind.
And then, after 2 years, I come to, and then,
And so, you know, as we do practice and meditate more and more, then we can, you know, make these minds, these subtle minds, you know, to function more and more.
我听你的大家来的，看你大家那么听，我们都开始马上往这些在讲，边坡的、地的那，做的讲那么一百的，那你这些可能都听到是他上那个开始不认识。So
I don't. That doesn't make sense that it is the same continuum. It's not the same, but it's the same continuum. And yeah, of course, if you can remember the past life, then that will help you to remember or think about, you know, the future lives. But you don't really have to remember, you know, the past life, you know, in order to think about the future lives.
그리 you look like that, okay? But we need to more investigation, checking. 다가지 소소로는 대바지기 상담 오래 쓰러와.
So something that is more suitable to your mind.
Okay. Then any other?
So if you're in meditation and you go back over the life you're in and you keep going back and you keep going back over a thing you're trying to find an answer to and you keep going back and you end up finding out who you were in another life or whatever, you know, you keep going back to try to find out what's the imprint in your mind that's causing it, you keep going back and then you don't ever hear of anybody knowing that they've been there or remembering it. And you go back and you keep doing this, and how do you know it's not a delusion that you're thinking when you're, you know, going back and then you think, oh, wow, you know, and you keep going back and say, oh, I was this in this life, and how do you know that's not a delusion?
他的电话嘛，搞了公交了，他电话嘛是他电话电话嘛，他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话嘛是他电话 really trace back, you know, to those lives, then that should be a special mind, right? That should be you know, some kind of a unique mind, because ordinary mind will not be able to trace all those lives, you know, in the past. So if you are able to trace that, then that is a special mind. So the, just being able to trace in that way shows that it's not illusion.
Thank you.
And what that is, okay. Then? Okay, then finish. Okay, thank you everybody.
Thank you.
I'm thinking about past, future, life a little bit. No, usually I'm always saying, you know, it is a Buddhism belief, path, push your life. And not just a Buddha said, we need to logic. We need to logic.
Use logic.
Use logic. Of course, for our Buddhism, we can explain each other. Buddha said, everybody, oh yeah, Buddha, all this course, the Buddha said. For someone else, say, yeah, I don't care, Buddha said, you know. Of course, you know, many people say, I don't care what Buddha said. If Buddha's very good for you, then I don't care Buddha, just whatever. Then, if you don't need to, you know, ask, argue with them, you know, say, we say, oh, of course, Buddha said, you have to believe, you don't believe Buddha, you're a bad person, you don't need to say that. It's not right. But if someone say, can you explain for me Buddhism, belief, path, pujala? Can you give me a reason? No, of course. Logically, then you need to keep logic. We need to understand that. This is more important, you know. And we don't need to, oh, because Buddha said you don't believe that, then you're bad. Just someone asked, can you explain, you know. Then we said, for example, today's mind comes from yesterday. Yesterday's mind comes from then go teenagers, then go mother's womb. And how they come, you know, all the phenomena, you know,
Compound phenomena.
They come from cause conditions. Without cause conditions, nothing could exist. Therefore, what they caused, what's the condition? Go back, go back, go back, go back. also, you book and you know,
so all the, you know, all the phenomena, the cause and conditions, and the cause, there is this the substantial cause and then the auxiliary cause. And so the substantial cause of the mind has to be a mind, and the substantial cause of a matter has to be a matter. So the substantial cause is something that changes into it, right? You know, the substantial cause of the mind has to be something that changes into a mind, and so something that changes in the mind can be only a mind, right? It's only the mind that comes from a mind, and it cannot come from the body, so it only comes from mind, and so it has to come from that mind and that mind, so trace back like that, then it will, you know, it has to go back into, you know, the previous lives. And so, for example, like the wood, you know, cannot, you know, produce iron, right? The iron cannot produce wood. That is because they have different substances. So just like, you know, and you can't grow, you know, you can't have the apple growing from the chili seed, right? You know, when you sow a chili seed, it only grows a chili, and it cannot grow apple from there. That's because there are different substances. So, for example, can offspring can come from a human being and animal sleeping together? That's because they're two different types, right? Different type of beings, different type of animal, sentient beings, right? So it has to be of same type.
I don't know, this is maybe not very nice example, but anyway, you can take logically. Therefore, mind need to look around that. She said, you charge me go. You know, she will get you. Did you get papa, papa, you know? Hey, you know, that something that tells you more. Think about the woman.
And so it is only the mind that comes from the mind, and therefore it has to be a mind. So this mind, there is this mind, so where did it come from? It came from yesterday's mind. And that was yesterday's mind. Where did that come from? That was this kind. And so you have to believe, because if it is there, then it has to have its cause, right? Without a cause, it cannot be there. So it has, if there is a cause, where is the cause? What is the cause? What is the substantial cause of that? The substantial cause of that is the mind. And it cannot be different mind, it has to be same continuum mind, so it has to be yesterday's mind. So yesterday, if you go back like that, then that's how you go back, you know, to the future lives.
Okay, anyway, look like that, but this very good to thinking, you know, it's very good to think about that investigation. If you think about more that things, then you are more understand. You are more understand, then you are more strong.
Your mind will become more stable, you know, to your practice.
Okay, thank you. Let me stop.
Thank you.
Please turn to page 39 of the.